It is the most hyped out of this world event in decades, and it is only 1 week away. Birds will fly to their nighttime roost, temperatures will drop, crickets will chirp, and bright stars and planets will become visible as day turns into night. Over the next few days, we will get you caught up on what you can expect and give you safety tips on how to safely view the spectacular event. This week's Eclipse 2017 coverage is being brought to you by Appalachian Wireless, where you can pick up your free Eclipse viewing glasses. Monday, August the 21st, the first total solar eclipse in the continental United States in 38 years will take place. Not many people had the opportunity to view the February the 26th, 1979 event because it only clipped five states in the Pacific Northwest. The eclipse this year is special in another way. This is the first time a total solar eclipse will travel coast to coast in 99 years, meaning everyone in the continental United States will see at least a partial eclipse, including right here in our area. But what exactly is a solar eclipse? We had the opportunity to talk to NASA scientist Dr. Alex Young about this highly anticipated event.
So on August 21st of this year, the Moon, Sun, and Earth will align up just perfectly so that the Moon comes between the Earth and the Sun and casts its shadow down onto the United States. And starting in Oregon, the core of its shadow, called the umbra, is going to travel across the U.S. at about 1,500 miles per hour, ending in South Carolina. And everyone in North America, Central America, and a good portion of South America are going to also experience a partial solar eclipse. And if you happen to be in that 70-mile-wide path that we just saw, then you will get to experience a total solar eclipse.
According to NASA, the lunar shadow will enter the west coast at 12:05 p.m. Eastern Time Monday. The first location to view the total eclipse will be Lincoln City, Oregon at 1:15 p.m. From there, the center line crosses 14 states, ending in Charleston, South Carolina at 2:48. The total eclipse will not last long. Carbondale, Illinois will experience the longest eclipse duration at 2 minutes and 43 seconds, while Hopkinsville, Kentucky will view the greatest eclipse. That is where the Sun, Moon, and Earth line up the most precisely. The lunar shadow then moves off the East Coast at 4:09 p.m. Eastern Time. If the weather doesn't cooperate or you are unable to view this eclipse, we have another opportunity for a partial eclipse in less than 7 years, on April the 8th, 2024. Tomorrow we will let you know exactly what our area can expect and what time to expect it. Stay with us. I'll have your forecast coming up next.